Hi, welcome to Tech Thursday, series where we look at technical problems and challenges in various analytical tools such as Excel, Tableau, Python, or SQL. Today we'll jump into Tableau to show you how to do a Pareto chart. As you can see now on my screen, I have a dashboard in Tableau that consists of some data from Olympics. That's exactly a Pareto chart. Pareto chart is a chart that basically has two charts on its own. First chart is cumulative numbers. Here we have medals won by each country. So we have USA, Russia, Germany, UK, France, and so on. You know that USA won about 5,500 medals. Russia won almost 4,000 medals, and so on. And so it goes. And they are sorted. They are sorted from the group, the attribute that has the highest number, to the lowest value. And then we have this crazy line here that goes and says, okay, 14%, 24%, 30-ish%, what does it mean? So this line tells you what share of the total amount these combined groups give you. So if we only look at medals won by USA, we know that's 14% of all of the medals won in Olympics. If we now look at USA plus Russia, this gives us 24% in total when looking at all of the medals won. And if we go along this line, you will learn that somewhere around 19th country, so this is South Korea, we have 80%. 80% of medals won is won by the countries that are here. So this gives you some kind of an insight, right? Look how many countries you have. And actually, 80% of those medals were won only by 19 countries. And this is exactly the so-called Pareto rule, which means 20% of your actions will give you 80% of your results. Or put it in different words, 20% of attributes, of groups, of entities will give you 80% of whatever you were measuring. Here, almost 20% of countries will give you 80% of medals won in the Olympics. Okay, but enough of the theory. Let's dive in how to actually calculate that, and then I'll tell you all about the coloring and lines and so on. Okay, let's create a new sheet to create this from scratch. What we need is, of course, we need our countries. So let's find it right here. And we need our medals. We actually need them as a continuous value, not a discrete value. Okay, we need to set this to a particular set, meaning the medal set, because the data we have here also gives us the like fifth place and so on. So we want only the medals. We can exclude this null country where we don't know the country actually. And let's maybe turn it around like this. And okay, this is basically the numbers of medals that we have per country, but this is not very telling, but you can see the USA here with the high number of medals won. So what do we want to have? We want to have them as sorted. So let's sort them actually. And let's sort them by field. No, descending. Yeah, exactly as we wanted. So you can see now, okay, USA, Russia, Germany, UK, and so on and so forth. Okay, and now we're gonna need this percentage line because we only know, okay, USA won this medals, Russia won this many medals, and so on and so forth. So we'll need to do a second line, second chart, so to say. So now we have two charts, and the second chart, we're gonna turn it into a line, and we're gonna make a table calculation. We're gonna add a table calculation, and this would be two steps. First steps will be running total. And you can see, okay, so we have USA won this many medals. If we add medals of Russia, we have this many medals. If we add medals of Germany, we have this many medals, and so on. So this is one thing, but now we actually want to turn this number into the percentage of total, because this would give us the point where the number of medals reach 80%, which in effect will give us the list of countries that contributes to 80% of all medals. So we click this add secondary calculation right here, and we add percent of total. See? And now I have this line. I can close this now. And now we just add missing bits. So first of all, I'm gonna add a label here. So I have these percentages. And now probably the trick that might be confusing to some of you that don't know this, I'm gonna make a dual axis. Here we go, we have dual axis, and now we'll just need to think about the coloring here and other bits. So Tableau, as you can see, changed the bars to circles. We want bars, so we want this like that. This is not working too well, so we're gonna drop that off. The line orange, well, we could keep it orange, but let's make it blue. Blue is not so eye-hurting, let's say. Okay, cool, we have that. And now the final bit, you might remember, was this coloring here. So we need the coloring so that we know where is the country that is the last that contributes to 80%. And for that, we have a formula. I already have it created here, so I'm going to show it to you. We are taking the running sum, then the count of the medals, and divided by total count of the medals. And you can see what? I don't understand that. So what I did was really, really cheaty, intelligent, because what you do, and let's just create a new calculated field. Okay, and let's delete whatever is here. I just put this line, so this exact formula here, and Tableau writes it. So this is the Pareto line here, and I don't need to bother with writing all that. All I need to bother is, I need to make, okay, this is within 0.8, meaning 80%. I click okay, and then I have a true false. And now, if I go here and I put this on the color, you see, I have a true, I have a false. So it gives me the divide where this line reaches 80%, which is South Korea. And now we can, of course, adjust the coloring. So if you remember, we had a bit of a different palette there. We had Tableau 20, I believe. So this would be green, this would be gray. Why? Because we, of course, want to highlight these countries. And now you might remember that here we had this first, second, third, and so on. So actually, someone could say, okay, I see those countries, but I don't actually know how many countries contribute to 80%, or, you know, I would need to count them as 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So what you need to do is you need to use an index, because if I would have an index here, I have a formula. It's very simple, you know, it's just index. That's what it is. If I'm going to convert to discrete, you know, if I'm going to put it on, let's say on a label here, see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 19. Okay, cool. But what I actually want to do, I want to have this, this not one, but first country, second country, third country, and so on. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove this field from marks, and I'm going to show this index place ending, which means if the index is 1, then we add ST. If the index is 2, then we add ND. And if it's 3, then it's RD. And then TH, like 4, 5th, and so on. So if now I add on the label this and this, I am going closer. Now I have to just edit the label. Go here. Say, okay, I want this just next to each other. I need to now change the alignment like this and put them at the bottom. Good. First, second, third, fourth, and so on. Let's look at here. Pretty much the same, isn't it? So this is how you create a Pareto chart, a chart that gives you the best of the best, that gives you the top 20% of the actions, top 20% of the group, that gives you 80%, or you would hope that it would give you, but basically it will show you when do you reach the 80%. For example, if you have sales, you can think, okay, which articles that I'm selling are actually contributing to the 80% of my sales? Which services I provide give me 80% of my customers? Or if you, for example, work at, I don't know, customer service and you manage complaints, what are 20% of all types of complaints that take 80% of all of the complaints I have? So this is exactly what the Pareto chart will help you with. So I encourage you to look at it. I encourage you to follow my steps. And of course, you can go to Tableau Public and check my profile there, where you'll find this same chart. You can download it from here. You can follow my steps and recreate the Pareto for your own use. Okay, that was Tech Thursday. I hope that was helpful for you. Let me know down in the comments, and for further tech challenges and solutions, please consider subscribing. Thank you so much. Have a good day.